Hey friends, Andrew here. Hope you're well. In my first review video of the MacBook 14 inch, I absolutely loved it. But now, having spent over 6 months with it since launch day, some things have changed. Over the last half year, some serious issues have come up, and some things, on the other hand, I love even more about the laptop. So here is my 6 month review where I'll give my honest opinion on whether this is still a laptop worth buying as a long-term investment. I've been using this laptop as the workhorse of my home office and desk setup, and I now have it docked to this LG 40 inch ultra wide display. This one here is the 14 inch MacBook Pro with the M1 Pro chip. Very specifically, this spec features a 10 core CPU, 16 core GPU, 1 terabyte SSD, and 16 gigabytes of memory. And this brings me onto the first point of issue here, which is the small memory. If I were to get this MacBook configuration again, I'd upgrade to either the 32 or 64 gigabyte configuration because I work with intensive 4K and 8K streams, and it does strain this build as powerful as it is already. You're probably wondering why I didn't go for it in the first place, because I was impatient and didn't want to wait for a custom upgrade on launch day. And secondly, I really appreciate the form factor of the 14 inch. Otherwise, I would have gone with the M1 Max chip, which starts with 32 gigabytes of memory anyway. The other downside I've run into is surprisingly the ports. Yes, there are more ports than ever, but I've run into issues with the SD card slot not working over the last few months. The card wasn't being read or just outright didn't show up, and I'm not sure how much of this is a unit specific issue actually. And although the expanded ports have been a great addition, I've still found myself wishing there was a USB-A port and particularly a direct display port 1.4 when I upgraded to the LG 40 inch ultra wide. Before we move on, a quick disclaimer. Yes, there are a few more negatives that I want to touch on and be upfront and honest about during my time with the 14 inch MacBook, but I do promise that I do have positives about this MacBook too. I have to comment on the draining battery performance, which has been a little disappointing. A laptop battery is designed to last for a maximum number of cycle counts before it needs to be replaced. For MacBooks produced in the last decade, including this MacBook here, the expected cycle count is about 1,000. Initially out of the box, I got about 12 hours of continuous usage on a single charge with demanding apps, but now taking this MacBook out on full charge, after 3 hours at a cafe, it runs down to about 60%, where it'd be 70 to 80% in its first few months of use. This type of battery degradation is significant enough to point out, and if you've experienced this too, I'd love to know in the comments. I'm probably at fault here though. I don't follow usual battery care usage guides. I leave mine docked all day long, but thankfully we still have access to fast charging, which grants a 50% charge from zero in just about 30 minutes and works on both the MagSafe 3 provided and docked via USB-C too. Talking about it being docked comes hands down the biggest issue I've run into during the last 6 months with this 14 inch MacBook. So when in clamshell mode, I've run into constant reset issues where my apps will randomly crash somewhat frequently and the entire laptop will also crash. In my personal experience, this is pretty rare for an Apple product, but yeah, it's something I've run into frequently, and unfortunately, it doesn't seem to be a unique issue to me either. After some digging, it seems like it's an issue others are facing with the 14 inch MacBook M1 when docked in clamshell mode. It's never been an issue I've seen, you know, with my previous docked 13 inch M1 MacBook, so it's pretty disappointing to see and something to be definitely aware of if you're considering using this in a docked setup. Does it happen frequently enough where it's unusable? No. But does it happen frequently enough to cause frustration? Yep, definitely. To be fair though, this could also be an issue with the accessories and aging CalDigit dock that I use, but I haven't been able to get to the bottom of it. Okay fam, that is enough negative Nancy vibes today. Let's move on to things that I still love, or love even more, about this laptop here after 6 months. The chunky, boxy shape and design has pleasantly grown on me. Sure, it's still not as sleek and slim as the previous 13-inch M1 MacBook, but it does have a pro aesthetic to it. And in fact, I've had a friend say she prefers the boxy look over her previous gen 16-inch MacBook Pro. I've also carried this laptop abroad to several countries since I got it, and I still think the 14-inch hits the sweet spot in both portable form factor and screen estate. It's not too big and not too small either, it's just right. And the display isn't just the right size, it remains the best laptop display I've used yet. The extremely bright 1600 nit liquid XDR Retina display is still as good as its fancy technical name implies, an incredibly crisp, vibrant, and smooth screen experience. It's really such a joy to use, and the mini LED screen paired with ProMotion is as impressive as it was since day one. So if you're planning to take advantage of the screen, especially if you're a creative or even just an avid consumer of media and videos, this screen isn't going to disappoint you. It's still one of the best screens you can get on a laptop as of right now. So I mentioned I would have considered the M1 Max chip more seriously if given the choice again, but I have to give credit where it's due to the M1 Pro chip. It is a big reason, if not the reason, to still make the upgrade an investment. The unified architecture that Apple has engineered, which has been finessed in the M1 Pro, continues to chug along and power everything I do without breaking much of a sweat. Almost nothing stutters under heavy load. Web browsing with more tabs than I can ever see? Check. Adobe Lightroom and Photoshop with large RAW files? Check. Huge Figma mind maps? Check. Having every single app open the dock? Also check. The only time the M1 Pro is challenged over the last 6 months that I've seen has honestly just been the 4K video editing with hundreds of clips on the timeline and rendering 8K files on Blender. To give you an idea, the 8K 3D file render estimation was about 20 hours on this MacBook Pro and only about 10 hours on a PC build with a dedicated Radeon 6900 XT. An unfair comparison, yes, and most people won't be crazy enough to need to render 8K 3D files. But my point, I guess, is there's still room for more processing power for the extreme power user, but for the majority, the M1 Pro provides more than enough juice to slice through your workflow with ease for years to come. The other big plus that has stood up over the 6 months is my love for this beautiful keyboard. I said it was one of the best keyboards that I've used, and it still is the best. It's so good that I look forward to bringing it to a cafe and answering emails there simply because the typing experience is so satisfying on this blacked out keyboard and anodized aluminium inset. Even the redesigned Touch ID is a joy to use and feels that much more premium. And also, yeah, I don't miss the touch bar one bit at this point. Heat dissipation hasn't been an issue either, unlike the previous gen that doubled as a hand warmer in winter. The only time I ever hear the fan on is when it's docked and I'm working with those huge 4 and 8K files. Otherwise, this thing is straight up a cold, silent assassin. And of course, the redesigned full HD webcam is still a noticeable and very welcome upgrade over the previous 720p webcam, which frankly should be retired in this day and age of working remotely. I personally haven't used it all that much in between using the iPad for FaceTime calls and the Logitech 4K Brio webcam I use for conference calls. But for those who rely on their laptop webcam as their go-to webcam, this is the one to have. So I'm going to make it simple for you. If you're thinking of upgrading or getting the 14-inch M1 Pro and it's within your budget, go for it. You are not going to regret it even after 6 months or even a year after its launch. This is even more the case if you want the power and don't want to compromise on the size. I genuinely think the 14-inch size is the true sweet spot for laptops. It's small enough to take around without breaking a sweat and big enough not to be straining your eyes with daily tasks. And almost every single aspect has been upgraded, from the speakers, display, keyboard, webcam, and of course the M1 Pro processor. Yes, it's still worth it even with the imminent M2 chip inbound. If you are a creative professional, power user, or someone who appreciates the cutting edge of tech like I think many of us on this channel do, then you may want to hold off until the M1-2 chip drops. But there are no guarantees with the future, and the only guarantee right now is the 14-inch MacBook Pro is beastly. It still is the gold standard in a portable, powerful, and stylish laptop, even with its flaws over the last 6 months. By the way, if you like the wallpaper seen on my laptop, it's an 8K render I've made, and I'll leave a link to it below for those who are interested. If you made it this far into the video, drop the code word comment gold standard, and I'll give it a like. If you have any questions at all about the 14-inch MacBook Pro, drop a comment down below. I'll do my best to answer as many questions as I can. And don't forget to like if you enjoyed this video, and sub if you want more tech business content from me. As always, thank you for watching.